马尔说是因为我们的这个 Sankirtan Yagya 做的，所以呢有这么多的鱼。
Okay, you can begin.
Yes, Maharaj.
Om Agyana
Recording in progress.
Timarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prastaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sanyavadi Paschacha De Satarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasati Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through the Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila, and we're on chapter number 15, where the devotees from Bengal are preparing to return to Bengal after visiting Jagannath Puri.
那我们现在呢，在阅读的是 Chaitanya Charitamrita 有关的 Chaitanya 经 Madhya Lila 中篇逍遥的第十五章。那么这一章讲的呢，就是在拜访了 Jagannath Puri 之后呢，孟加拉的奉献者就准备要返回孟加拉去了。Lord
Chaitanya is spending time with each of the devotees to give them personal instructions.
所以，Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，就花时间和所有的这些奉献者们在一起，然后分别的给每一位奉献者以相应的训示。So
the next devotees to meet with Lord Chaitanya were Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and his brother, who's called Vidya Vachaspati.
那么，下面一位见 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的呢是 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 以及他的弟弟 Vijaspara. Vachaspati.
Vidya.
Vidya.
Vachaspati.
Vachaspati. Vidya Vachaspati.
Yes, he's the brother of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
He's Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's弟弟.
So Lord Chaitanya told them, he said, in the Kali Yuga, Krishna is manifest in two forms. One is a form in wood, and one is a form in water.
他说呢，在这卡利年，是Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu对他们说呢，在这卡利年代，Krishna他以两种形式展现，一种呢是以木头的形式展现，另外一种呢是以水的形式展现。So
in this way, all the conditioned souls who see the wood and who bathe in the water, they can become liberated.
所以呢，在这样的方式呢，使得所有的这些受条件限制的灵魂看见了这样的木头，以及在水中沐浴，就能够得到解脱。Lord
Jagannath is the supreme Lord in the form of wood.
所以主 Jagannath 呢，他是在木头形式里的至尊主。And
the river Ganga is the supreme Lord in the form of water.
而刚刚河，也就是恒河呢，是至尊主以水的形式展现出来的形象。From
the Vedas, we know that everything is the energy of the Supreme Lord.
在伟达经里面，我们就知道了，所有的一切都是至尊主的能量。Everything
is a manifestation of Brahman.
而且所有的一切呢，都是 Brahman 的展现。
So that we also know that the energy and the energetic are this identical. So Brahman is the energy and Supreme Lord Krishna is the energetic.
So Brahman, 就这个梵光呢，它是一种能量，而至尊主 Krishna 它是能量的拥有者。
So everything is actually Krishna.
所以呢，实际上所有的一切都是 Krishna.
And from the Bhagavad Gita, we also learn, Krishna says, in the ninth chapter, verse number 4, he said, and by me, in my unmanifested form, the entire universe is pervaded.
然后在《薄伽梵歌》的第九章的第四十节里面，然后 Sri Krishna 他就说到，通过我，通过我的这个能量，是整个的宇宙都展现了。
Right, the unmanifested means the avyakta, avyakta murtina. The avyakta murtina means the unmanifested form of Krishna.
就是通过我未展现的形象，显现了整个宇宙。
So,
Krishna 的未显现的形象。
So, he said this unmanifested form is pervading everything.
他说呢，就这个未显现的这个形象呢，是无处不在，遍存万有的。
Just like the super soul is everywhere.
那么就好像超灵，它是无处不在的。
And then Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, all beings are in me.
然后是 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌里面又说呢，一切的生物都在我之中。
But I am not in them.
但是呢，我却不在他们之内。
So Krishna in his impersonal form is spread everywhere in the universe.
所以呢，是 Krishna 以他非人格的这个形象，便存在整个宇宙之中。
Right, that Krishna's Brahman, the impersonal Brahman, is spread everywhere.
所以 Krishna 他是 Brahman， 他是非人格的梵光，他无处不在，遍存万有。
So Krishna's energy is everywhere.
所以 Krishna 的能量是无处不在的。
And Krishna can appear through any of his energies.
而且 Krishna 呢，他可以通过他所有的能量而显现。
So in this age, Krishna comes in the form of wood as Lord Jagannath.
所以在这个年代呢 ，Sri Krishna 他就是在主 Jagannath 这样的形象，以木头的形式显现。
And he also appears in the Kali Yuga in the form of the river Ganges.
而且呢，他在卡利年代呢，他也是以恒河的这个形象显现在水里的。
So Lord Chaitanya told these two brothers, he said, "You should worship Lord Jagannath and the river Ganges."
所以说呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就对这兄弟俩说呢，你们就应该崇拜主 Jagannath 以及恒河。
And then he told specifically, he said, "Sarvabhum Bhattacharya," he said, "You should worship Lord Jagannath here in Jagannath Puri."
然后就特别的对 Sarvabhum Bhattacharya 说呢，你就应该在这儿，在 Jagannath Puri 来崇拜主 Jagannath。
And Vachaspati, you should worship Mother Ganga.
而 Vachaspati, 你呢应该崇拜恒河，母亲恒河。
So in this way, Lord Chaitanya gave the two brothers their duty.
所以有这样的方式呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就把这个职责派给了这两兄弟两位。
So then the next person to come and see Lord Chaitanya was a devotee called Murari Gupta.
那么下一面一位来见 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，是被称为叫 Murari Gupta 的这位奉献者。
Murari Gupta had a house very near to the home of Lord Chaitanya in Mayapur.
Murari Gupta 的家，他在 Mayapur， 就是 Murari Gupta 在 Mayapur 的家呢，离 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在 Mayapur 的家是很近的。
So he knew Lord Chaitanya. He'd watched Lord Chaitanya grow up as a child.
所以说他是从小看着 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 长大的。
And he witnessed all the different pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
而且呢，他也见证了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的所有的逍遥的显现。
And now Lord Chaitanya is taking sannyas.
可是现在呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 接受了 sannyas 的进阶。
But Murari Gupta is still devotee. He's still.Following Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
但是呢 ，Murari Gupta 呢，他依然在遵循着 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的足迹，他依然是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的奉献者。
So Lord Chaitanya embraced Murari Gupta.
所以呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就拥抱了 Murali Gupta。
And then in front of all the devotees, Lord Chaitanya began to speak about Murali Gupta's great faith in devotional service.
然后呢，当着所有的奉献者的面，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就开始讲述 Murali Gupta 对就是对这个奉爱服务的极大的信心。
Actually, Murari Gupta was a devotee of Lord Ramachandra.
事实上呢Murari Gupta 他是主 Ramachandra 的一位奉献者。
But Lord Chaitanya told Murari Gupta, he had, when the Lord Chaitanya, when he was a householder, before he took sannyas, he was telling Murari Gupta, he said,You should just worship Lord Krishna.
但是呢，当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 还是一位居士的时候，他当时呢就对 Murari Gupta 说：“你应该只是崇拜 Krishna。”
He told him, "Lord Krishna is the supreme sweetness."
他对 Murari Gupta 说：“主 Krishna 是至尊的甜美。”
And Krishna is the source of all the incarnations.
Because Krishna, he is the source of all the incarnations.
He is the reservoir of all pleasure.
And he is the reservoir of all pleasure. And he is the reservoir of all pleasure.
And he is pure transcendental love.
He is pure transcendental love.
Krishna is like a reservoir of all transcendental qualities.
那么 Krishna 呢，它就好像是一切的超然的品格的蓄水储藏库。
He is expert at everything.
那他是精于所有一切的。
He's very intelligent.
他非常的聪明。
His character is very sweet.
而且呢，他的这个性格呢，非常的甜美。
And his pastimes are melodious.
他的逍遥时光呢，也是，就是如歌般美丽的。
And he enjoys all pastimes.
他享受着所有的逍遥时光。
So Lord Chaitanya told Murari Gupta, just worship Krishna, take shelter of him.
所以呢，去 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就对 Murari Gupta 说呢，你只是崇拜 Sri Krishna， 求得他的保护。
Apart from service to Krishna, nothing else will be pleasing or satisfying to the mind.
因为呢，除了服务 Krishna 之外，没有其他的任何事情能够让的这个心意变得那么的心满意足、快乐。
So Lord Chaitanya told him again and again, just worship Krishna.
所以呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就一次又一次的对他说，只是崇拜 Krishna。
But his mind would not be changed. Murari Gupta's mind would not change.
但是呢 ，Murari Gupta 的心意就不会变，他就心意觉得要崇拜 Ramachandra。
Murari Gupta told Lord Chaitanya, "I'm your servant and I'm your order carrier."
然后呢 ，Murari Gupta 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我是你的仆人，我呢是你的命令执行者。
I have no independence from you.
我不可能独立于你而存在。
So then that night, Murari Gupta went home, and the whole night he was thinking that he would have to stop worshipping Lord Ramachandra, and he would just have to worship Krishna.
那所以呢 ，Murari Gupta 呢，他那天就回家了，他脑子里面就在想着，他必须要停止崇拜主 Ramachandra， 他必须要开始崇拜 Sri Krishna 了。
So Murari Gupta prayed to the lotus feet of Lord Rama.
所以呢 ，Murari Gupta 他就 在主 Ramachandra 的莲花足前祈祷。
He prayed to Lord Ramachandra, "Let me die now tonight."
他对主 Ramachandra 说，今天晚上就让我死吧。
Because it's not possible for me to give up the service of the lotus feet of Lord Rama.
因为呢，我根本就不可能放弃对主 Ramachandra 莲花足的服务。
So better, but Lord Chaitanya has asked me to worship Krishna, and I'll have to disobey his order. So better, I just die.
但是呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢又训令我要崇拜 Sri Krishna， 所以我肯定就得违背他的命令。那最好还是让我今天晚上就死了得了。
So Murari Gupta cried the whole night.
所以 Murari Gupta 他整晚都在哭泣。
His mind could not rest.
He
stayed awake the whole night. And the next morning, he came to see Lord Chaitanya, and he caught hold of the feet of Lord Chaitanya, and he cried.
第二天清晨呢，他就来拜见 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 然后他一把抓住 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的莲花足，就开始哭了起来。
He told Lord Chaitanya, "I have given my life to the lotus feet of Lord Ramachandra."
他对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说我把我的生命都献给了主 Ramachandra。
I cannot take my mind away.From Lord Ramachandra.
我没有办法使我的心意离开对主 Ramachandra 的冥想。
I cannot give up my service to Lord Ramachandra. I cannot give up my service to Lord Ramachandra.
我没有办法放弃对 Sri Ramachandra 的服务。
But at the same time,if I don't stop serving Lord Ramachandra, then I'm breaking the order which you have given me.
但与此同时呢，如果我要是不放弃对主 Ramachandra 的服务的话，那也就意味着我破坏了您所给我的序约。
So what should I do?
所以我该怎么办呢？
So Murari Gupta asked Lord Chaitanya, "Tell me, what do you want me to do?"
So Murari Gupta 就向 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 问询着，请您告诉我，我应该怎么办？
"You are all merciful," Murari says to Lord Chaitanya. "You are very merciful. Let me die now in front of you, so that I can have no more doubts."
Murari Gupta 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，您是非常仁慈的。所以现在就请让我在你的莲花足前死掉吧，这样我就不会再有任何的困惑了。
So Lord Chaitanya picked Murari Gupta up and embraced him.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就扶起了 Murari Gupta， 然后把他拥到了怀里。
And Lord Chaitanya told him, "Your method of worship is very good."
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Murari Gupta 说，你的崇拜的方式是非常好的。
Lord Chaitanya said, "Even though I've asked you to give up the worship of Lord Ramachandra, your mind cannot give it up. That's very good."
所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，即使我让你放弃对主 Ramachandra 的崇拜，你的心意都没有办法离开对 Ramachandra 的崇拜，这是非常好的。
If we are going to serve the lotus feet of the Lord, we have to have that kind of love and attachment for the Lord.
如果我们要是服务主的莲花足的话，我们就必须要对主有这样深情的爱，以及这样深情的依附之情。
Even if the Lord wants to separate from us, the devotee will not give up his lotus feet.
即便是主想跟我们分开。这个奉献者他也不会放弃主的莲花足。
So this is a real method of devotional service.
那么所以这个呢是对于奉爱服务的真法。
Yeah, just like we say Prabhu. Prabhu means the master. So we should never give up the service of the master.
就像我们会称呼 Prabhu 的意思呢是主人，也就是说呢，我们永远都不要放弃对主人的服务。
So the original Prabhu is Lord Krishna.
那么最原初的 Prabhu, 最原初的主人就是 Sri Krishna.
But there are many devotees who also worship Lord Ramachandra. And Marari Gupta is one of these devotees.
事实上有很多奉献者都是在崇拜着主 Ramachandra 的， Marari Gupta 就是其中的一位。
He would never give up the worship of Lord Ramachandra.
也就是说呢，他永远都不会放弃对主 Ramachandra 的崇拜。
Even though Lord Chaitanya is telling him to give it up, he doesn't give it up.
对，即便是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对他说放弃对主 Ramachandra 的崇拜，他也不会放弃。
That is the real chastity of devotional service.
这个就是奉爱服务的真正的贞洁所在。
So a devotee should never give up the service of the master.
所以说呢，一位奉献者他永远都不要放弃对主人的崇拜。
Under any circumstance, we should never give up the worship.
无论在任何一种情形之下，我们都不要放弃对主的崇拜。
And if the devotee chooses to leave, then the Lord himself will come and bring us back.
而且如果要是这位奉献者他选择离开的话，那么主他会亲自前来把我们再带回来的。
He'll drag us by our hair, drag us back.
他会扯着我们的耳朵把我们给拖回去的。
We see sometimes devotees, they leave Krishna consciousness, but then Krishna brings them back.
我们就会看到有的时候奉献者他会离开 Krishna 知觉，但主呢又会把他给找回来了。
After some time, maybe sometimes not even in this life, maybe we have to wait till the next life, but Krishna will arrange to bring us back to devotional service.
但是呢，找回来也许可能不会在这一生把他找回来，可能还得再等下一世。但是呢，无论如何 ，Sri Krishna 会把这个人再重新的再带回到奉爱服务中。
Devotional service is eternal. It goes on. It doesn't finish. It doesn't stop. It keeps going, life after life.
奉爱服务它是永恒的，它是不会停止的，它是会生生世世的这样延续下去的。
So even though there may be many obstacles and many difficulties, many people may be telling us, "Give this up, stop doing this." We don't give it up. We just continue to do it.
OK, 那么也许可能我们会面对很多的障碍，也许可能我们会面对很多的艰难。有些人会让我们说，把这件事情放弃吧，不要再做这件事情了。但是无论怎么样，我们都不会放弃，我们都会继续做下去。
So Krishna wants to test our faith.
So Krishna 他是要考验我们的信心的。
Just like Lord Chaitanya was testing the faith of Murari Gupta.
就好像 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他在考验 Murari Gupta 的信心。
So Lord Chaitanya was telling him again and again, just worship Krishna, don't worship Lord Ramachandra.
就像 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 一次又一次的跟他说，要停止崇拜主 Ramachandra, 只是要去崇拜主 Krishna.
But Lord Murari Gupta would never give up the worship of Lord Ramachandra.
但是呢 ，Murari Gupta 他从来就不会放弃对主 Ramachandra 的崇拜。
So then, finally, Lord Chaitanya congratulated Murari Gupta. Lord Chaitanya congratulated Murari Gupta that you have so much faith and so much devotion for Lord Ramachandra.
Yeah, 然后所以最终呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就恭喜了 Murari Gupta。说的你对于主 Ramachandra 有这么多的信心，有这么多的爱。
And he told Murari Gupta, "You are the incarnation of Hanuman."
然后呢，他对 Murari Gupta 说呢，你就是 Hanuman 的化身。
And so you are the eternal servant of Lord Ramachandra.
所以说呢，你是主 Ramachandra 的永恒的仆人。
So you can never give up the worship of Lord Ramachandra.
所以说呢，你永远都不可能放弃对主 Ramachandra 的崇拜。
Yeah, there are many examples, Lord, how Hanuman was so attached to Lord Ramachandra. He would only serve Lord Ramachandra.
那有好多好多的事例都讲述了 Hanuman 是多么的依附于主 Ramachandra, 他只是去崇拜主和服务主 Ramachandra.
So one time, they told Garuda, go and tell Hanuman to come and see, Krishna wants to see him in Dwarka. So, go ahead.
Right. 对，那就有一次呢，这个哈努曼被就派就是 Krishna 派 Garuda 去找哈努曼，然后对哈努曼说，赶紧现在立刻去见 Krishna， Krishna 想要召见你。
So Hanuman just sat there. He didn't go anywhere.
但是哈努曼呢就坐在那儿一动也不动，哪儿也没去。
And so then Garuda came back to see Krishna, and Krishna said, "What happened? Why did you tell him to come and see me?"
然后呢，Garuda 就回来找见 Krishna， 然后 Krishna 就问他发生了什么事情，你没有跟 Hanuman 说让他来见我吗？
So he said, "Yeah, I told him to come and see you in Dwarka." He said, "You should have told him to come and see Lord Rama. Go and tell him now. Come and see Lord Rama. Lord Rama wants to see him."
然后，Garuda 就说：“我跟他说了，我跟他说让他来 Dwarka 见您，见 Krishna。”然后 Krishna 说：“你不能跟他这么说，你不能跟他说来见 Krishna， 你要跟他说来见 Rama， Rama 想要见你。”
So Garuda flew back and he told Hanuman, "Lord Rama wants to see you in Dwarka." So immediately Hanuman was going to go to Dwarka, and Garuda said, "I can take you on my back."
然后呢，格鲁达他就又飞回了哈努曼的身边，对哈努曼说，你赶紧去努尔克，主 Rama 想要见你。所以呢，哈努曼立刻就赶紧要去见，主 Rama。然后格鲁达说，你可以骑到我的背上，我可以驮你过去。
But Hanuman said, "No, it's okay. I'll go on my own."
然后哈努曼说，没事儿，没事儿，我自己可以去。
And so when Garuda came back to Dwarka, he saw Hanuman was already there before him.
所以呢，当 Garuda 他回到 Dwarka 的时候，发现 Hanuman 已经在那儿了，先于他已经到了 Dwarka。
So Hanuman has that enthusiasm for the service of Lord Ramachandra.
所以说呢，哈努曼他对于主 Ramachandra 的服务总是充满着热情的。
And even they tell Hanuman, you know, that actually they say, "Lord Rama, he's just a form of Lakshmi Narayan. Lord Sita and Rama are just Lakshmi Narayan. You should worship Sita and Narayan. They are the original form of God."
Who said? Who said that?
Devotees.
Okay. 然后呢，奉献者呢就对这个对这个 Hanuman 说这个 Rama 跟 Sita 不过就是 Narayana 和幸运女神 Lakshmi 的这个形象，所以呢，你就应该直接的崇拜主的 Narayana 和幸运女神的这个形象就好了。
But Hanuman said, "No, it's okay. I just want to worship Sita and Rama. I don't know anyone else but Sita and Rama."
然后 Hanuman 说，没事儿，没事儿，我呢就只想崇拜 Rama 跟 Sita 和 Ram， 除了他们俩之外，其他人我都不认识。
I don't care if they're the Supreme Lord or not. I just want to worship them.
他们到底是不是至尊人格守神，我不管，我只想崇拜他们。
So this is the nature of Hanuman's love for Sita and Rama.
所以这就是 Hanuman 对 Sita 和 Ram 的爱的本性所在。
And Murari Gupta, he has that kind of attachment for Sita and Rama.
所以 Murari Gupta 呢，他对于 Sita 和 Rama 就这样的依附之情。
So in Mayapur, there's a temple of, at the birth, there's a place where Murari Gupta's house used to be, and now there's a temple of Sita Ram there.
在 Mayapur 呢，就是昔日 Murari Gupta 的老宅的那个地方呢，现在在那里建起了 Ram Sita 的庙， Sita Ram 的庙。
So every year we go there to visit the home of Murari Gupta.
每年呢，我们都会到那儿去参观 Murari Gupta 的家。
And we remember all of his pastimes with Lord Chaitanya.
然后呢，我们就在那儿会忆念 Murari Gupta 和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所消上演的所有的这些小时光。
Murari Gupta kept a diary of all the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya.
Murari Gupta 他有记一本日记，这日记里面呢就记了所有的 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的逍遥时光。
So that diary was very valuable when people were writing books like the Chaitanya Charitamrita and the Chaitanya Bhagavat.
那所以说呢，就是这本日记呢是非常的珍贵的。那么比如说当人们在开始，就是对于关于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这些书籍的著作，这本日记是非常的珍贵的。比如说像 Chaitanya Charitamrita、Chaitanya Bhagavat 这些书籍，在写作的时候
，The people who wrote these books, they didn't actually see the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya, but they wrote these books guided by the diaries of Murari Gupta.
因为这些书的作者们，他们其实并没有亲眼的看到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这些逍遥时光，所以呢，他们就必须要根据参考 Murari Gupta 所写的日记来撰写他们的书籍。
So then the next person, Lord Chaitanya said, he said, I accept Murari Gupta as my life and soul.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我把 Murari Gupta 看作是我的生命与灵魂。
Said Lord Chaitanya said, when I hear of his humility, then it perturbs my very life.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，当我一想起他的，我一想起他的这个谦卑之情，就让我的这个生命发生翻搅。
Murari was he was a very humble soul. He would never go to the front. He always wanted to stand at the back.
Murari Gupta 他是一位非常谦卑的灵魂，他永远都不会站到人前，他总是躲在人后。
Lord Chaitanya would have to ask, where is Murari Gupta? And he would be way at the back, behind all the devotees.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 每次都得问 Murari Gupta 在哪儿，然后呢才会发现他远远的在所有的奉献者的后面。
And they'd have to bring him forward to be near Lord Chaitanya.
而且呢，大家就只能够，把这个 Murari Gupta 给带到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的面前。
So then the next devotee to meet Lord Chaitanya was a person called Vasudev Datta.
然后下一位，被 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 接见的呢，是被称为叫 Vasudev Datta 的奉献者。
And when Lord Chaitanya was speaking about him, he was glorifying him as if Lord Chaitanya.It was as if Lord Chaitanya had 1,000 mouths.
那么当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在荣耀 Vasudev Datta 的时候呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就好像有1,000张嘴一样。
So when Lord Chaitanya began to glorify Vasudev Datta, he became very embarrassed and shy.
那么Vasudev Datta became very embarrassed and shy,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
OK， 然后呢，当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 开始荣耀 Vasudev Datta 的时候呢 ，Vasudev Datta 就变得非常的害羞，非常的腼腆。
嗯 ，So Vasudev Datta. Vasudev Datta fell at the feet of Lord Chaitanya and touched his lotus feet.
所以呢 ，Vasudev Datta 他就拜倒在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的莲花足前，触碰他的双足。
Vasudev Datta said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, you have incarnated just to deliver all the fallen souls.
然后 Vasudev Datta 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，您化身前来就是为了要拯救所有的这些堕落灵魂。
So I have a petition I want you to accept.
那所以说呢，我有对您有一个请求，希望您能够接受。
Vasudev Datta says,To Lord Chaitanya, I know you're able to do whatever you like.
然后 Vasudev Datta 对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，我知道您可以做到您想做的一切。
And you're very merciful.
而且呢，您是非常仁慈的。
So it will be very easy for you to do whatever you want.
任何你想做的事情对你来说都是小事一桩。
So Vasudevdatta said, "My heart breaks to see the suffering of all the conditioned souls."
然后 Vasudevdatta 就说，当我看到所有的这些受条件限制的灵魂在受苦的时候，我的心都碎了。
So I want you to transfer all the karma of their sinful lives to me.
所以呢，我就希望你能够把所有的这些堕落灵魂的罪业的业报全部都转到我的身上。
Let me suffer eternally in the hellish condition.
所以让我在这地狱般的境界中永远的受苦。
Let me accept all the sinful reactions of all these people.
让我接受所有的这些人的罪业反应。
And let them finish their material life.
让他们就结束他们的物质生活吧。
So this was the prayer of Vasudevdatta.
所以这就是 Vasudevdatta 他所献上的祈祷。
Just like in the Western world, in Christian culture, they talk about Lord Jesus taking the sins of all of the people.
那么就好像是在这个西方国家的这个基督徒们，他们总是会讲耶稣基督他拿走了所有的这些人身上的罪。
Yeah, they say Jesus died for our sins.
他说呢，他们会这样说，他们说耶稣是为我们的罪而死的。
So here we have Vasudevdatta, and also we have devotees like Haridas Thakur.Who are very advanced devotees.
那所以说我们在这儿呢就听到了 Vasudevdatta, 还有呢比如像 Haridas Thakur 也是非常的精进的奉献者。
Because they were willing to deliver everyone.
因为他们的愿望呢是想要拯救所有人。
But Jesus Christ was only interested to deliver his followers.
但是呢，耶稣基督他的这个他只有意于要去解救所有他的追随者，他的信徒。
But Vasudevdatta, he's ready to accept the sins of everyone in the universe.
但是呢 ，Vasudevdatta 呢，他是想要接受在就他想要承受在这宇宙中的所有人的罪。
So Vasudevdatta is much, much more compassionate than Lord Jesus Christ.
所以呢，与耶稣基督相比呢 ，Vasudevdatta 他所具有的怜悯心是要深厚的多的多的多的。
The devotee, the Vaishnava, is so compassionate that he is ready to risk everything just to deliver the conditioned souls.
所以呢，作为 Vaishnava， 因为他是非常的怜悯，非常的具有同情心的，所以呢，他就希望，他愿意冒一切的危险，做出一切的牺牲，来拯救这些受条件限制的灵魂们。
So Vasudevdatta knew Lord Chaitanya was the Supreme Lord.
那 Vasudevdatta 他知道 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢是至尊主。
So Lord Jesus Christ.He could finish the sinful reactions of his followers by his mercy.
那耶稣基督呢？他可以通过他的仁慈来停止他的信徒们的罪恶的反应。
But that doesn't mean he delivered them from material existence.
但是那并不意味着他就把他们从物质的存在中给拯救了出来。
Just like we know that Christians, they come.They will come and they will confess their sins, but then they go on and commit more sins.
就好像我们知道，这基督徒他们会为自己所做的、所犯下的罪进行告解，但是当他们做完告解之后呢，他们又会去犯更多的罪。
So they may get freed from their sins one time, but it doesn't mean they stop sinning. They continue to sin.
所以说，也许可能他们会。摆脱他们所犯下的罪，他们可能就是从他们所犯的罪的一次中解救出来，但是并不意味着他们就不再犯罪了，他们会继续再去犯罪。
So if they keep sinning, they're not going to get free from material life.
所以如果他们要是继续不断的去犯罪的话， 那也就意味着他没有办法从物质的生活中得到解脱。
Just like you may get sick and you go to the doctor and he cures your disease, but you may get the disease again.
那么就好像是我们生病了，然后呢，我们就去看大夫，然后呢，大夫就给我们吃了药，我们就从这个病中就治好了。但是呢，我们也许可能还会再生病的。
So the material disease continues.
所以说呢，这个物质的疾病它就会继续。
But Vasudev Datta, he wants to free the conditioned souls from all their suffering so that they would not have to suffer again.
但是呢 ，Vasudev Datta 呢，他是希望，使这个受条件限制的灵魂从他们所有的罪中得到解脱。那这样的话呢，他们就不会再在这个罪中受苦了。
He doesn't want them to have the chance to commit sins again.
他不想让他们还会再有犯罪的机会。
So this is the difference between Lord Jesus and Vasudev Datta.
所以这就是耶稣基督和 Vasudev Datta 之间的区别。
So it's very offensive. You may get forgiven for your sins, and then you keep sinning. It's very offensive.
我们也许可能从我们所犯的罪中得到了原谅，但是呢，我们又继续的去犯罪。其实这是非常冒犯的。
Yeah, it's if you do sinful activities, that's sinful. But if you get forgiven for your sins, and then you keep sinning, then it's very offensive.
如果我们要是犯了罪，那么这个呢是有罪的。但是如果我们要是犯了罪被原谅了。然后呢，我们又继续去犯罪的话，那么这个是非常的冒犯的。
So Vasudev Datta was so kind, he requested Lord Chaitanya to give him all the sinful reactions.
所以呢 ，Vasudev Datta 他是非常的慈悲的，他请 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 把所有的这些罪恶的反应全部都转嫁到他的身上。
Let the conditioned souls be purified and go back to Godhead.
然后呢，让这些受条件限制的灵魂能够得到净化，然后能够回到守神的身边去。
So Vasudev Datta, his example is unique in the world. It's very, very special.
所以 Vasudev Datta 他在这个世界上所给我们树立起的这个典范是非常的独特的。而且呢，也是非常的特别的。
嗯。Okay, so no one should consider Vasudev Datta. We shouldn't think of Vasudev Datta as just being a welfare worker.
但是呢，我们不能够把 Vasudev Datta 看成是一个福利工作者。
And he was not interested in impersonal liberation.
而且呢 ，Vasudev Datta 他对于非人格的解脱也毫无兴趣。
And he didn't want material honor or reputation.
他也不希望有任何的物质的尊重，或者是有任何的好的声誉。
But he was he was the most exalted person to show mercy.To the conditioned souls.
但是呢，他是向受条件限制的灵魂展现仁慈的最崇高的人物。
There's nobody actually to compare to Vasudev Datta.
最高尚的人物，那世界上没有任何一个人是能够和 Vasudev Datta 相比拟的。
Yeah, we say that the Vaishnava devotee should be para dukkha dukhi.
那我们说呢 ，Vaishnava 或者奉献者应该是 para dukkha dukhi.
Means they're very sorry to see other people suffer.
也就是说呢，当他们看到其他人受苦的时候，他是感到很难过的。
Materialistic people, they enjoy seeing other people suffer.
但是物质主义者呢，他们其实是非常享受的看着其他人的受苦。
But a devotee feels very sad to see people.Suffer.
但是一位奉献者，当他看到别人受苦的时候，他感到很伤心。
So devotees like Vasudev Datta, they purify the whole world.
像 Vasudeva Datta 这样的奉献者，他净化了整个世界。
Okay, so, when Lord Chaitanya heard Vasudeva Datta say that he wanted to take the sins of all the people, then Lord Chaitanya's heart became very soft.
当时 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 听到 Vasudeva Datta 他想要承载所有人的罪的时候， Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的心就变得非常的柔软。
And then tears came up, tears began to flow from the eyes of Lord Chaitanya.
然后泪水就从 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的眼中流淌涌流而出。
And he began to tremble.
而且 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就开始颤抖起来。
So Lord Chaitanya accepted Vasudeva Datta as a great devotee of the Supreme Lord.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就把Vasudeva Datta 给看成是至尊主的一位非常伟大的奉献者。
He said, "For you to speak like this, it's not astonishing, because I know you are the incarnation of Prahlad Maharaj."
他说呢，对于你能够讲出这些话，其实也不是那么的让人惊讶。的原因是由于我知道你是 Prahlad Maharaj 的化身。
So Lord Krishna has shown complete mercy upon you.
所以呢 ，Sri Krishna 把他完全的仁慈显现在你的身上。
And there's no doubt about it. You've got the full mercy of Krishna.
这是毫无疑问的，你从 Sri Krishna 那里得到了完全的仁慈。
Whatever, when a pure devotee wants something from Krishna, then Krishna will have to give it.
每次当一位纯粹的奉献者想和 Sri Krishna 那里要一些东西的话，那么 Sri Krishna 是一定会把这个东西给这位纯粹奉献者的。
Krishna has to fulfill the desires of his devotees.
因为 Krishna 他必须要满足他的奉献者的愿望。
So Lord Chaitanya told Vasudeva Datta, "If you desire to deliver all the living entities within,"
Sri Krishna 他是具有全然力量的，他可以立刻把我们所有之前不好的业报都给拿走。
So Lord Chaitanya is telling Vasudeva Datta that you're very eager for the welfare of all the conditioned souls. You want them to have good fortune.
所以 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对 Vasudeva Datta 说，因为你非常的渴求，所有的这些受条件限制的灵魂有好的归宿，你就是你希望他们都不受苦。
So all the living entities in the universe will be delivered by your desire.
所以说呢，就是因为你有这样的愿望，使得在这世上的所有的生物体都会得到解脱。
And there's no need for you to suffer for their sins.
那所以说呢，也不需要你去为他们的罪而受苦。
If somebody gets your compassion, they will immediately become a devotee.
那如果要是某人接受了你的仁慈的话，接受了你的怜悯的话，那他立刻就能够成为奉献者。
As soon as someone surrenders to Krishna, it can become a Vaishnava immediately.
当一个人他一皈依于 Sri Krishna, 他立刻就能够成为一名 Vaishnava.
Krishna promises to take away all their sinful reactions.
因为 Krishna 他做出了承诺，他要拿走他们所有的罪恶的反应。
Of course, you have to fully surrender to Krishna.
那当然，你必须要完全的皈依臣服于 Krishna。
Then you get freed from all the sinful reactions.
当这么做了以后呢，你就能够摆脱所有的罪恶的业报反应。
And without getting freed from sinful reactions, we cannot become a devotee.
但是呢，如果我们要是没有摆脱我们所有的罪恶的反应之前，我们是没有办法成为一名奉献者的。
So all of our sinful reactions are finished when, as soon as we surrender to Krishna and engage in His devotional service.
所以说呢，当我们 意向 Krishna 皈依，并且呢开始从事于对他的关爱服务的时候，我们所有的罪恶的反应都得到了清除。
So there are many statements in the scriptures to support this.
所以在经典中呢，有好多这样的陈述来支撑这个观点。
Anybody who surrenders to Krishna, they get rid of all their karma.
任何一个皈依于 Krishna 的人就能够摆脱他们所有的业报。
But if you don't surrender to Krishna, then you remain and suffer all your karma.And that's true for everyone.
但是如果你要是不依靠不臣服于 Krishna 的话呢，那么任何一个不归于 Krishna 的人，他都始终都会让自己始终被困缚在他的业报中受苦。
King Indra, the king of heaven, he's enjoying and suffering his karma.
天地之王 Indra, 他就始终在为他的业报而享受或者受苦。
And the Indra Gopa, there's a tiny insect called the Indra Gopa. That's also his karma. That body of the tiny insect is his karma.
那么有一个被称为叫 Indra Gopa 的一种小的虫子，那么这个也是他所他的这个业报所致，就是他也在他这个非常小的这个躯体里面，在这个享受或者是在受着他的业报之苦。
But Krishna destroys the karma for somebody who does devotional service.
但是呢，当一个做了奉爱服务的人 ，Krishna 就会摧毁掉他的业报。
So Lord Chaitanya told Vasudev Datta, because you desire everyone to be delivered, Krishna will deliver them.
那所以说，释迦牟尼妈妈就对 Vasudev Datta 说。因为呢，你的愿望是，解救所有的人，所以呢，Sri Krishna就会解救所有的人。
And then Lord Chaitanya gave an example. He said, just like there are millions of fruits on this Udambara tree.
然后呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就给了一个例子。他说呢，就好像是在这棵乌丹巴尔树上有成百上千万个果实。
So in the same way, there are millions of universes floating on the water of the river Viraja.
同样呢，在 Viraja 河上就漂浮着成百上千万个宇宙。
Alright, Mahavishnu, he's laying on the causal ocean, and from his body, all the universes are coming out.
那主Mahavishnu 呢，他就躺在元阴之阳里，然后从他的躯体里面呢，就出现了所有的这些宇宙。
So this Viraja River is between the material and the spiritual world.
那么这条 Viraja 河呢，是 Viraja 河呢，是在物质世界和灵性世界之间的这个位置。
On one side of the Viraja River is the Brahma.Is the material universes.
那在 Viraja 河的一边呢，是所有的这些物质的宇宙们。
And you can see Brahma, you can see Vaikuntha. On one side, you can see Brahma Loka and all the Vaikuntha planets.
They're on one side or on the.
Well, on one side there's the material world, the other side is the spiritual world.
Yeah, 那就是在这个 Viraja 河的一边呢是物质世界，另外一边呢是灵性世界。
So on one side you can see the Vaikuntha planets.
那所以说呢，所以在一边呢，你可以看到所有的这些Vaikuntha 的星宿。
On the other side you can see all the universes.Material universes.
那么在另外一边呢，就看到的都是这些物质的宇宙。
So the side of the Viraja River is filled. One side of the Viraja River is filled with the material planets, which are floating in the causal ocean. with the material planets, and they're floating in the causal ocean. Hare Bo? Oh. Hare Krishna? Hare Krishna? Hare Krishna? Hare Bo? Hare Krishna?
Hare Krishna, Gurudev.
Yeah.
可能单的有一点不稳定, 我们稍等一下。
Mm-hmm.
Hare Krishna, Dana Kini Manaji. 要不您先下一下, 然后再重新上一下。
Krishna，丹尼，您现在说一下，能听见我说话吗？我这因为我两个来上的，稍等一下啊。
能听见，现在非常没有回音。对，我现在是这样的，因为我用电脑和用手机都上了，我现在不知道是，但是我电脑那边的呢是被
mute 住的，开不开，所以我现在我不知道到底是我现在手机在说话还是电脑在说话，应该是手机可能。反正现在效果还挺好。 哦，那就先这样，那就那是手机的，好吧，那就先这样，不好意思啊，大家，不好意思啊，刚才不知道我突然出现了啥问题，那就先这样，OK，谢谢。Marge，sorry, sorry, I don't know what's wrong with my connection, but right now I'm using my phone.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I had to do that one day.
Thanks.
All right, so we were describing how planets are floating in the causal ocean, in the material, on the material planets, they're floating in the causal ocean.
所以呢，我们刚刚就讲到了，就是在这个原因之阳上就漂浮着所有的这些物质的宇宙们。
And the Viraja The Viraja River is between the material and the spiritual worlds.
而 Viraja 河呢，它就是在物质世界和灵性世界中间的这个位置。
So the Viraja River is not material. It's not under the control of the material energy.
但是呢，Viraja 河呢，它并不是物质的，它并不是被物质能量所控制着的。
So there's a tree which is called Udambara tree, and it has many millions, hundreds and thousands of fruits.
那么在那儿呢，有一棵树，这棵树呢被称为叫 Udambara 树。那么在这棵树上呢，有成百上千万颗果实。
So if one fruit falls down and gets destroyed, it's not a big loss.
所以如果要是有一颗果子从树上掉下来，并且被砸烂了的话呢？
So Lord Chaitanya says, in the same way, if one universe is emptied and all the living entities are liberated, it's not a very big thing.
所以呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，就如果要是有一个物质宇宙中的所有的灵魂都得到了解脱，被弄空了的话，这并不是一件什么大事儿。
Krishna doesn't take that very seriously.
Krishna 他并不会把这件事情非常的这个严肃的去看待的。
Because Krishna has so many universes.
因为呢 ，Krishna 他有那么多的宇宙。
So the whole spiritual world shows the unlimited opulence of Krishna.
那所以整个的灵性世界呢，都在展示着 Sri Krishna 的富裕。
And there's an infinite number of Vaikuntha planets there.
而且呢，在那个地方呢，是有无限的 Vaikuntha 的星宿。
The causal ocean is surround it's separate from the Vaikuntha locus.
但是呢，这个原因之阳。它是和瓦昆特星宿分离而在的。
And Maya has unlimited material universes in the causal ocean.
而 Maya 呢，在原因之阳里面有着无数的物质的星宿。
So just like there's a pot filled with mustard seeds.
就好像是有一个罐子，这罐子里面呢是盛满了芥末籽。
So in the pot, there are millions of mustard seeds floating.
那么在这个罐子里面呢，上面漂浮着成百万上千万的芥末籽。
So if one seed is lost, it's not a big problem.
所以如果是只是失去了一个芥末籽的话呢，并不是什么大事儿。
Just like if one universe is lost, it's not very serious to Lord Krishna.
所以说呢，如果要是失去了一个宇宙的话，对于 Sri Krishna 来说，并不是什么大的损失。
So, if one universe is just like one mustard seed.
所以一个宇宙它就像是一颗小芥末籽一样。
If all the universes and the material energy are destroyed, it's not a problem for Krishna.
如果要是在物质能量中的所有的这些物质宇宙全部都被毁掉了的话，对于 Sri Krishna 来说呢，也不是什么问题。
So then Lord Chaitanya gives another example. He said, just like a person may have millions of wish-fulfilling cows.
然后呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他又给了一个例子，他说就好像有一个人，他有成百上千万头如愿乳牛。
And then he loses one goat.
He 然后呢，他就失去。
Yeah, he lost a goat.
然后他就失去了其中的一个居所。
No, goat.
Goat, 他失去了他失去了其中的一只山羊。
So he has a million of Kamadhenu cows.
但是呢，他有成百上千万头 common dino 乳牛，不愿乳牛。
So he doesn't worry about one goat.
所以如果他只是失去了一头山羊的话，他不会为这一头山羊而担忧的。
So Krishna has all six opulences in full.
那么因为 Krishna 他拥有全部的六项富裕。
So if the entire material energy is destroyed, it's not a problem for him.
所以如果要是整个的物质能量都被摧毁了的话，对于 Sri Krishna 来说不是什么问题。
So we have to understand conditioned souls often forget, they forget Krishna. When they're attracted by the material energy, they forget about Krishna.
那我们要知道，这个受条件限制的灵魂，当他们被物质能量所吸引的时候，他们经常会做的一件事情就是把 Krishna 给忘了。
We fall under the influence of the material energy, and we think about, we're sent into the material universes, and we try to enjoy the material world.
因为呢，我们是被处在这个物质能量里面，然后呢，我们被送到了这个物质世界，就是物质能量的物质世界里面，然后我们就想要去享受这个物质世界。
And we try to enjoy the fruit of all activities in the material world.
我们就想要去享受的在这个物质世界里面的所有的这些物质果实。
And so we enjoy something and we suffer also.We get some enjoyment, but we get also suffering.
但是呢，我们就会在这个物质世界里面会得到一些享受，会得到一些快乐。但与此同时，我们也会受苦。
But if we become Krishna conscious, then the karma of our good karma and our bad karma is all destroyed.
但是如果我们要是具有 Krishna 知觉的话呢，那么我们的业报，无论是好的业报和坏的业报，都会被清除掉，会被摧毁掉。
We get free of all the reactions of our karma.
也就是说呢，我们会摆脱掉所有以前的业报给我们造成的反应。
So just by the desire of a devotee, conditioned soul can be liberated and get free of their karma.
那么就像是如果是一位奉献者有这样的一个愿望的话呢，那么这个受条件限制的灵魂他就会摆脱所有的这些坏的业报。
So we can understand it's by the will of the devotee that the material world exists or not.
所以说我们可以明白，就是在一位奉献者的愿望之下，使得这个物质世界它或者是处于存在的状态，或者是不存在的状态。
Or we could say it's not just the will of the devotee, but it's the will of Krishna.
那实际上我们可以这样理解，其实这并不仅仅是一位奉献者的愿望，这其实是 Krishna 的愿望。
If Krishna desires, he can completely annihilate the material creation.
如果要是 Krishna 他愿意的话呢，他可以彻底的瓦解，这个物质的创造。
There's no loss on the part of Krishna.
但是呢，在 Sri Krishna 的这一边，他是没有任何损失的。
Just like the man who's got a million Kamadhenu cows, he doesn't worry if he loses one goat.
所以，就像一个人，他如果是拥有百万头 Kamadhenu 如愿乳牛的话。他如果要是只是失去了一头山羊，他是没有任何损失的。
So Lord Krishna is the proprietor of the material and the spiritual worlds.
所以 Sri Krishna 呢，他是物质世界和灵性世界的拥有者。
The material world is only 1/4 compared to the spiritual world.
然后呢，这个物质世界呢，它其实。只是占整个的四分之一而已，和灵性世界相比。
So Krishna is so opulent that he won't mind to lose something.
那所以说呢，Sri Krishna他因为是非常的富裕的，所以呢，他就是失去了点什么，他也不用担心。
Krishna's opulences are so complete, unlimitedly. So we say Krishna has got three potencies. There's the internal, the external, and the marginal potency.
一个是外在能量，还有一个是边际能量。
So when we forget Krishna, then we're put under the external potency.
所以当我们忘记Krishna的时候呢，我们就被放置在了外在能量里。
And the three modes of material nature, they keep us in the material world and cause us a lot of pain and suffering.
这个物质自然的三属性呢，就把我们始终给滞留在这个物质世界里面，然后呢，让我们经受着很多的痛苦。
We're always afraid of being controlled by the material energy.
而且我们总是很害怕被物质的能量所控制着。
So we should always pray to Krishna to help us to conquer the material energy, to conquer over Maya.
所以呢，我们总是要向Krishna祈祷，祈祷着我们能够征服物质能量，能够征服Maya。
And then Maya will not be able to show power anymore.
如果这样的话呢，Maya她就不会再展示她的雄威了。
The Maya keeps all the material, the living entities in the material world keeps us all under her control.
Maya 呢，是Maya把我们给滞留在这个物质世界，让我们都处在他的控制之下。
But if we pray to Krishna, then we can get freed.
但是如果我们要向Krishna祈祷的话呢，我们就能够得到解脱，就能够得到自由。So
Lord Chaitanya was describing about the good qualities of his devotees, one after another.
所以呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，就这样在点数着他的奉献者的一个又一个美妙的品质。And
he would embrace them, and then he said goodbye to them.
然后呢，他会拥抱他的奉献者们，然后和他的奉献者们道别。Feeling
separation from Lord Chaitanya, all the devotees began to cry.
因为感受着和Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的分离之情, 所有的这些奉献者们都开始哭了起来。And
Lord Chaitanya was also morose. He felt also morose, feeling separation from the devotees.
想着和这些奉献者们的分离呢, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu也感到黯然神伤。
But Gadadhar Pandit decided he was going to stay. He wasn't going to go back to Mayapur.
但是Gadadhar Pandit呢，他就决定要留下来，他不打算再回玛雅国了。So
Lord Chaitanya arranged a place for Gadadhar Pandit to stay.
所以呢，主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢就安排了，让Gadadhar Pandit 安顿下来的地方。
Gadadhar Pandit, of course, he'd been a friend with Lord Chaitanya from their childhood. They'd grown up together.
那当然，从小呢，Gadadhar Pandit 就是。 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的好朋友，他们俩是一起长大的，发小。So
when Lord Chaitanya took sannyas, then Gadadhar Pandit also wanted to come there and be with him in Jagannath Puri.
当 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 接受 sannyas 启迪的时候呢，Gadadhar Pandit 当时就想和Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 一起到 Jagannath Puri 定居。
And Lord Chaitanya was, of course, very happy to have Gadadhar Pandit with him because together they used to associate together a lot. And Lord Chaitanya would come and Gadadhar would read Srimad Bhagavatam to Lord Chaitanya.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 去看 Gadadhar Pandit 的时候呢， Gadadhar Pandit 就会为他诵读圣典薄伽瓦坛。
And Lord Chaitanya was very fond to hear about the pastimes of Dhruva Maharaj and Prahlad Maharaj, and he would hear these sections of Srimad Bhagavatam again and again.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢非常的喜欢聆听 直果 Maharaj 和 Palad Maharaj 的小时光，所以说呢，他就会反复的、不断的聆听圣典婆伽瓦坛对于这些小时光的讲述。
So there were a number of devotees staying at Jagannath Puri with Lord Chaitanya. He had his servants and some sannyasis also were there with him.
所以说呢，就有一些奉献者就留在了 Jagannath Puri 和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在一起。那还有和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在一起的呢，是一些仆人，还有 sannyasi。
Servants were like Govinda and Kashishwara. They'd come to serve Lord Chaitanya.
仆人呢，有比如像 Kashishwara， 还有像 Govinda， 他们都在那儿服侍着 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
And sannyasis like Paramananda Puri.
那像 sannyasi 呢，有 Paramananda Puri。
And then Swarup Damodar is there, of course, because he's like very intimate associate of Lord Chaitanya.
Swarup Damodar 在那里，那这是毫无疑问的，因为呢，他是 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 非常的亲密的同游。
So every day Lord Chaitanya would go to see Lord Jagannath in the morning.
所以每天呢 ，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 都会在清晨的时候去拜见主 Jagannath。
So one day Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya came to see Lord Chaitanya and he had a special request to Lord Chaitanya. So he came folding his hands and begging permission.
So 有一天呢Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就来拜见 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. 他对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 有个请求，所以呢他就双手合十的想要得到 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的恩准。
So he wantedthat he said, now all the Vaishnavas are going back to Bengal. So he said, now I want you to come to my home and take prasadam.
他说呢，因为现在所有的奉献者们都已经回孟加拉的家里了，所以现在我希望请您能够到我家里面来荣耀 prasadam.
He said, I want you to come every day for a month to my home.
我希望您能够每天都到我家里来荣耀 prasadam， 一直来一个月的时间。
But Lord Chaitanya said, "No, no, that is not possible. That is against the religious principles of a sannyasi."
所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说：“不不不，这可不行，这个是不可能的，因为这是打破了 sannyasi 他要遵守的宗教原则的。”
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya then said, "Well, please."Accept the invitation for 20 days. If you cannot come for 1 month, then please come for 20 days.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 说，那如果是这样的话，如果您要是不能够来我们家吃一个月的饭的话呢，那您至少应该来我们家20天的时间。
But Lord Chaitanya said, this is not a religious principle for the sannyasi.
但是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，这对于 sannyasi 来说不符合他要遵守的宗教原则。
So then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, then please come for lunch for 15 days.
然后 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 说，那这样的话，那请您上我们家来荣耀15天的午餐。
So Lord Chaitanya said to him, I will come for lunch to your place for 1 day only.
然后 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我只上你家吃一天午餐。
So then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya fell at the feet of Lord Chaitanya. He grabbed his feet and he begged him, please, please come for lunch for at least 10 days.
然后呢，是Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就拜倒在主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的足前，并且抓住他的莲花足，对他恳求道，求你了，求你了，上我们家至少吃10天的午餐吧。
So in this way, Lord Chaitanya reduced, finally they agreed 5 days.
那他俩就这样讨价还价，最终呢 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就同意了上他们家去荣耀5天的午餐的 prasadam.
And so for 5 days, Lord Chaitanya would go to Lord Bhattacharya's home to take lunch.
那所以说就这样在五天中呢Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 都会到 Bhattacharya 的家里面荣耀午餐。
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya then said, there are 10 sannyasis who stay with you.
然后 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 接着说呢，有十位 Sanyasi 和您一起居住。
So Sanyasis are not supposed to cook food for themselves.
那么作为 Sanyasi 来说呢，他们是不应该为自己做饭的。
And they should not accept invitations to go continuously to a person's home for many days.
而且呢，他们也不能够连着几天的接受到某一个人的家里面的邀请去吃饭。
That's why he would not accept the long invitation to go to Sarvabhauma's house every day for lunch.
也就是这个原因呢，使得Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他就不能够接受Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 对他提出的一连这么多天的到他们家去吃午餐。
He accepted only 5 days in the month.
所以呢，他只接受了就在这一个月里面去他们家5天的时间。
And there are 10 sannyasis staying in Jagannath Puri with Lord Chaitanya. So they would all come with Lord Chaitanya to take the food.
那所以呢，因为在 Jagannath Puri 和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在一起的还有十位 sannyasi， 所以呢，他们都和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 一起去供养 prasadam。
But maybe not all 10 would go.But Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, well, at least Paramananda Puri would come for 5 days.
But Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, well, at least Paramananda Puri would come for five days.
And Swarup Damodar is the intimate friend, so he will come sometimes also.
而且呢 ，Swarup Damodar 呢，他是一位非常亲密的好友，所以呢，他有的时候也应该来。
So that's 2 sannyasis. Paramananda Puri is going to come, and Swarup Damodar will come sometimes.
所以说呢，这已经是两位 sannyasi 了，一位呢是 Paramananda Puri 每次都跟您来，然后呢 Swarup Damodar 呢，时常的来一下。
And the other 8 sannyasis, they will take 2 days each.
然后剩下的八位，sannyasi 呢，他们就分，就是轮班的，每位来2天。
And so there'll be for every day of the month there'll be sannyasis coming there to take food.
那所以就这样一来呢，就使得在这一个月里面，每天都会有 sannyasi 到 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 的家里面去供养午餐。
Lord Chaitanya would go for 5 days.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢是去5天。
And Paramananda Puri would also visit for 5 days.
然后呢 Paramananda Puri 呢也会去供养5天。
And Swarup
Paramananda Puri is not going with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu together for the 5 days, but separate. So
Paramananda Puri for 5 days. Then Swarup Damodar, he would come also alone for 4 days.
然后呢 ，Swarup Damodar 呢，他也会自己独自来 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 的家里面吃饭，吃4天。
And the other 8 sannyasis, they would come for 2 days each.
那然后剩下其他的那些 sannyasi 们呢，就是每天都会，就是每一位都会连着来2天。
So in this way, 30 days of the month will be filled up.
那就这样的方式呢，就使得这一个月的30天就被填满了。
Because if all the sannyasis came at the one time, it wouldn't be possible to give them proper respect and take care of them.
因为如果要是所有的这些sannyasi们都一块儿来的话呢，那就没有办法能够把他们都照顾得非常的好，都不能够很恰当的照顾他们所有的人。
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya worries he may become an offender if he doesn't take proper care of them.
所以呢 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 他就担心，如果要是他不能够很好的照顾这些 sannyasi 们的话，那他就变成了一个冒犯者了。
So sometimes Lord Chaitanya would come alone, and sometimes he would come with Swarup Damodar.
So 有的时候呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他会独自前来，但有的时候呢，他是会 和 Swarup Damodar 一起来的。
So Bhattacharya said, immediately today you must come. We'll begin today. Today you come and have lunch at my home.
然后呢 Bhattacharya 说您就应该从今儿开始立刻您今天就应该上我们家来吃饭。
So we'll stop here today.
好的，我们今天的讲课呢就先到这儿。
Ask if there's some questions.
看看大家有没有什么问题，如果有问题的话就先提出来啊。Yes, Marge, here is one question from Yuna.Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my very humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada.How can we understand where is karma and where is Krishna's intention? Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我谦卑的顶拜，一切荣耀都归是了 Prabhupada。 那我们如何能够理解，哪里是 karma， 而哪里是 Krishna 的意图呢？
Well, karma is also coming from, it's comingIt's under the control of Krishna.
这个 karma 它其实就这个业报啊，它其实也是在 Sri Krishna 的控制之下的。
Karma is the reactions of the material energy.
业报呢，它是物质的能量的反应。
So if you're under the three modes of material nature, so your suffering is due to karma.
那所以如果我们要是在物质自然属性的控制之下的话，那我们就会由于业报而受苦。
But if you've surrendered to Krishna, then you should have got free from the three modes of material nature.
但是如果你要是归于 Krishna 的话呢，那就应该是从这物质自然三属性中解脱出来了。
So then your suffering is, any suffering you experience is the arrangement of Krishna.
所以那这样的话你在这会儿的这个受苦的这个体验呢就是 Krishna 的安排。
And your suffering is the arrangement for your purification.
而且呢 Krishna 他之所以会安排这样的痛苦呢是为了要让我们得到净化。
To bring you back to Krishna, to bring you back home, back to Godhead.
他之所以给我们这样的安排呢是为了要把我们带回到 Krishna 的身边，带回到守身的身边。
Sometimes Krishna wants us to finish up all of our karma so that we can go back to Godhead.
那有的时候呢 ，Krishna 他就想要让我们结束所有的业报，这样呢，我们就能够回到他的身边去了。
So sometimes he may give us some suffering just to finish off all of our karma.
所以呢 ，Krishna 他有的时候呢就会让我们受一些苦，他的用意呢就是为了让我们结束我们所有的业报。
But a devotee always thinks that whatever suffering he's got, it is due to his past sinful activities.
但是呢，作为一位奉献者，他的这个思维方式呢，就是无论他受了什么苦，他这个苦全部都是由于之前所做的坏事而导致的。
There's a verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam which says, "Tate nukampam susamikshamana."Bunjana evatma kritam vipakam. That the devotee accepts all the reactions, all the difficulties, the sufferings which he undergoes, he accepts them as being reactions due to his past sins.
那么在这个圣典不教法坛里面有这么一个师节，就是一个奉献者，他会接受所有的这些业报的反应，所有他所经历的这个痛苦，全部他会认为这是由于他之前的罪恶的活动的咎由自取的业报反应。
But he goes on suffering. He goes on suffering. He goes on rather doing his devotional service. He doesn't stop his devotional service. He continues to do devotional service.
但是呢，在他受苦的这个过程中呢，他不会停下他做奉爱服务，他会继续的去从事他的奉爱服务。
And in this way, he becomes qualified to go back to Godhead.
那以这样的方式呢，就使得他变得具有了回归守身的资格。
So the material difficulties which a devotee undergoes is for our purification.
所以说呢，一位这个奉献者他所经历的这些物质的艰难，其实他都是为了要让我们得到净化。
So you should think whatever suffering we've got is due to our sinful reactions.
但所以呢，我们应该是这样想的，就是我们所受的这些痛苦，全部都是由于我们的罪恶活动的业报反应。
And we should very intensely engage in devotional service.
而且呢，我们要非常的就是非常的热情的一直让自己处在从事 Krishna 的服务奉爱服务之中。
And we should think that the suffering which we're undergoing, that suffering.It's our karmic reaction, it's also the arrangement of Krishna.
那我们应该要觉得就是我们现在所受的这个痛苦，一方面呢是我们的业报反应，另外一方面呢这也是 Krishna 的安排。
And we should think, I'm meant to suffer more, but Krishna has reduced the suffering.
那我们要想的是，其实呢我要受的苦要更多，但是呢 Krishna 他把我们的这个痛苦给减少了。
And when we're not suffering, when we're enjoying, like we have some good karma, we should think, I don't deserve all of this. We should think, this Krishna's just trying to encourage me.
但是如果我们要是没有受苦，而我们过的这个生活还不错的话，那我们应该在想，其实呢，我本来不应该有这样的，就我本来不应该有这样的生活，但是 Krishna 他之所以安排我现在有这样的生活的原因呢，是因为他要鼓励我。
嗯哼。Okay.
Yes, Marge. The next question from Saraswati, Mataji from Beijing Center. 他说到呢，这个 Hare Krishna 礼拜 Guru 礼拜翻译和主持人以及所有的奉献者礼拜您 ，Krishna 必须满足他的奉献者的愿望。奉献者什么样的愿望 ，Krishna 就能够满足呢？跟物质有关的愿望 ，Krishna 会满足吗 ？Hare Krishna Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances to you and to all the devotees. Krishna must fulfill the desires of his devotees. So, what kind of desires of the devotee will be satisfied by Lord Krishna? What about those desires related with material?Desires. What are those material desires are also will be satisfied or fulfilled by Lord Krishna?
Well, when we say Krishna will fulfill the desires of the devotees, this means the desire of his pure devotees.
就是当我们说 Krishna 会满足奉献者的愿望的时候，这个奉献者指的是他的纯粹奉献者。
Pure devotees have no material desires.
因为纯粹的奉献者他是没有物质欲望的。
The pure devotees, they simply desire for the pleasure of Krishna.
因为作为一个纯粹奉献者，他的愿望呢是为了要让 Krishna 开心，就是他的愿望就是要取悦 Krishna.
Because they're pure devotees, they're always engaged in devotional service. They're always chanting the holy name of the Lord. They're always endeavoring for the service of Krishna and bowing down before Him.
那么作为这个 Sri Krishna 的纯粹奉献者呢，他时刻都是在为 Sri Krishna 做奉爱服务的。他时刻都是在唱诵 Krishna 的圣名。他时刻都是在向 Sri Krishna 顶礼。
They don't want anything else but service to Krishna.
他们除了想要服务 Krishna 之外，别的什么都不想要。
Pure devotees, they cannot, they will never desire any material sense gratification.
那么，作为一位纯粹的奉献者，他永远都不会想着要去享受任何的感官上的满足。
So Krishna reciprocates. He wants to fulfill the desires of these pure devotees.
那所以说呢 ，Krishna 他是会回应的，他想要去报答，这个纯粹奉献者的愿望。
Pure devotees like Vasudev Datta, who wanted to deliver all the conditioned souls.
那就比如说像 Vasudev Datta 这样的纯粹奉献者，他想要做的事情呢是解救所有的，受条件限制的受苦的灵魂们。
All the people of Vrindavan, they only desire for the pleasure of Krishna. They have no desire for their own self.
作为 Vrindavan 的所有的这些居民们，他们，所有的愿望都是想要怎么去取悦 Krishna. 他们从来就没有任何一个要让他们自己感到满足的愿望。
So Krishna will fulfill the desires of his pure devotees.
所以说呢 ，Krishna 就会满足他纯粹奉献者的愿望。
And the pure devotees, they just desire for the service, for the pleasure of Krishna.
而作为纯粹奉献者呢，他的愿望就是要取悦 Krishna， 要想着怎么去更好的服务 Krishna。
So if you have some material desire, that's not pure devotion.
那所以说呢，如果要是我们还有一些物质的愿望的话，那也就意味着这不是纯粹的关爱服务。
Okay.
Yes. No other questions.
Oh, really?
Right. Hare Krishna, 亲爱的奉献者们，你们还有没有要请教咕噜的问题呀、啊？Jaya Sachinanda Mataji's question. 顶拜敬爱的 Guru Day, 感谢翻译，谢谢您。请问，非生物里，例如石头和木头里有超灵吗？如何理解无所不在？Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances to you. My question is that for those non-moving entities, for example, like the stone and wood, are there any super soul in there?How to understand that the super soul is everywhere, is all pervading?
Yes, the super soul is all pervading because it's within the atom.
超灵呢，它是无处不在的，因为呢，超灵它是也在这个原子里面。
So the super soul is everywhere, within the stones, within the air.
所以说呢，这个超灵它是无处不在的，它在石头里，它也在空气中。
So I think Jai Sachinandan Prabhu's question is that is there a jiva within these things? Is there a jiva soul?
所以说呢，对不起啊，刚才把这个Jai Sachinandan。跑步的这个，别说错了，说他妈的怎么去跑步？就是顾问您，您的问题是在就是像石头、木头这些不动的这个物质里面有没有基瓦个体灵魂存在是吗？您的问题是这个对吧
？The super soul is everywhere. Yeah, you're right. The super soul is everywhere because we said that's in the Vedas, in the scriptures, it said everything is Brahman.And Brahman is the impersonal energy of Lord Krishna. So that's everywhere.
对 那首先呢这个您是对的就是超灵它是无处不在的。因为呢就是这个 Brahman 是无处不在的。而这个 Brahman 呢它是主的非人格的能量那它是充斥在一切之中的。
Right.Krishna said, we quoted the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, by me, in my all-pervasive form, the entire universe is pervaded.
我们在这选这个引述圣典佛家梵歌的话，他说呢，这个通过我的非人 through my impersonal energy, I am all pervading.
Yes.
Right. 对，就是就是Krishna他说，通过我的非人格的能量，我无处不在，变成万有。
You can check Bhagavad Gita chapter 9, text number 4.
对，我们来看一下啊，就是佛教颂歌的第九章的第四十节。
Krishna says, Mayatatam Jagat Sarvam Jagat Avyakta Murtina. Right? The Avyakta Murti, the unmanifested form of Krishna. This is the all pervading feature of Krishna.
Krishna, he said,
Right. So Krishna is pervading everything by this Avyakta Murtina, the unmanifested form.
那所以呢，所以Krishna他是通过这个Avyakta Murtina不展示的形象。
And then if you read the 10th chapter, at the end of the 10th chapter, Lord Krishna in chapter 10 has been describing his opulences. And he listed many opulences, he said, of mountains I am the Himalayas, and of mountains I am Meru, of immovable things I am Meru, of mountains I am Meru, of the rivers I am the Ganga, of beasts I am the lion, all of these different things, right? Many different opulences.
然后呢，如果我们要是看《佛家梵歌》第十章的话呢，佛家梵歌在 Sri Krishna 在《佛家梵歌》里面就列举了他的这些富裕，比如说他说在这个在山在群山中我是喜马拉雅，在不动的事物中我是梅鲁山。然后呢，又说在这个，动物中，说是狮子，就是类似于像这样的说了很多。
And then at the end of the chapter, Lord Krishna says, "But what? There's no need for all of this detailed knowledge, O Arjuna."
但是呢，在《佛家梵歌》的第十章的最后一节呢，Sri Krishna又说，但是 Arjuna， 就是不需要去了解所有的这些。
He said, with a single fragment of myself, I pervade and support the entire creation.
他说呢，我只有极微小的一部分就遍布并维系了这整个宇宙。
So, what is that fragment of Krishna which is pervading and supporting the entire creation?
那么所以说呢，就是这个。Krishna 的这微小的这一部分遍布了整个的宇宙的那是什么呢
？We will ask Jai Sachinandan Prabhu.
那这个问题是提给 Jai Sachinandan Prabhu 的。
你可以回答吗 ，Jai Sachinandan？
Jai Sachinandan Prabhu， 不如邀请您回答一下这个问题，就是这 Krishna 说他这极微小的这一部分遍布被。并维系了整个宇宙，这一个微小部分指的是什么
？Right, that is. That is actually okay. We'll answer for him. That is the super soul.
咕噜说他替你回答这个问题了。他说这个就是那个超灵。
And then in chapter 7, Krishna said.Everything rests on me, just like pearls are strung on a thread.
然后呢，在第圣殿佛家梵歌第七章里面，然后 Sri Krishna 说，所有的一切都栖息我以上，就栖息我之上，就好像是珍珠穿在线上。
So
Maharaj Sachini Jai Sachinandan Prabhu said that he typed slowly, so that's why he didn't answer just now.
Okay. All right. So we see many references in the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna establishes his all pervasiveness, that he's everywhere in everything.
那所以说呢，在《佛家梵歌》里面，其实有很多的这个证据， 都是Sri Krishna向我们展示的，他是遍存万有，无处不在的。
He's the super soul in everything.
那么他是以他的超灵，存在于万事万物之中的。嗯。嗯。我和顾说了，说您打字慢。
嗯。
然后下面这个问题，下面这个问题是来自于海瑞尼玛的记得。顶拜咕噜，顶拜所有的奉献者，请问种一棵秃拉西树跟种多棵秃拉西树有什么区别？答案咕噜的回答。Harinimaji asked, "What are the differences in between of a plant one tula plant versus plant multi tula bushes? What are the differences?"
One tulsi and many tulsis.
Yes.
Well, there's no difference.
没区别。
It's all an opportunity to do devotional service.
那么这个都是就是给我们一个能够做奉献服务的机会。
Some devotees, of course, they will like to have a supply of tulsi leaves to offer for their offerings to Krishna.
那有些奉献者呢，也希望能够。能够得到一些托拉西的叶子，然后呢，能够在给 Sri Krishna 做供奉的时候呢，能够用这些叶子。
And they would like to collect the manjari flowers from the tulsi trees.
然后呢，他们愿意是就是剪 ，you mean cut, right?
Yeah.
然后呢，他们愿意就是他们可能会把这个秃西树上的这个 manjari 的这个小花给它剪下来。
And they will offer these manjaris to Krishna.
然后呢，他们就会把这个 manjari 小花献给 Krishna.
And so, if you only have one tree, you may be stressed sometimes. You don't get enough leaves, and sometimes also tulsi leaves the body. And so, it's safer to have more than one tree.
所以呢，就如果是只种一棵秃拉西的植物的话呢，那有的时候我们可能就会觉得没有足够的叶子可以供奉，而且有的时候呢，秃西它可能也会离开躯体，所以呢，就为了保险起见呢，种多个多过一棵的秃西比较保险。
It's actually a sign of devotion. If tulsi is growing in your house and you have more trees, it means you have a lot of devotion, because tulsi only grows where there is devotion.
这个秃西啊，它只会在有奉爱氛围的地方成长。所以就是，如果是在家里面有多过一棵，长得很好的秃西的话，那都是一个标志，就意味着，在这个家里面有很多的奉爱的奉爱的氛围在这里面，表示着你有很多的奉爱。
You should remember, Tulsi is not an ordinary plant, but she is a holy tree.
We should remember, Tulsi is not an ordinary plant, but she is a holy
tree.
Thank you, Maharaj. Then the next question from Subhita Sangha Mamji. Hare Krishna, Dibai Guru, 请教咕噜，现在已经是启迪了的门徒，如果至死都没有摆脱玛雅的钳制，至死还有躯体化概念，但念诵圣名、听咕噜的讲课，这样做能完美回家吗？Sugita Sangha Maharaj's question is that please accept my humble obeisances to you, Guru Maharaj. My question is that.For those devotees who have already got initiated, however, they are still to be clutched or controlled by Maya, and also always hold the very strong concept for body concept. But they are chanting holy name and also hearing the lectures from spiritual masters. In this case, do they have any chance?To be perfect and go back home.
Oh yes, they have a very good chance.
他们的这个机会是很大的。
They just have to continue chanting the holy name and hearing about Krishna.
那他们要做的事情呢，就是不断的继续的念诵圣名，然后呢，聆听关于 Krishna 的话题。
And gradually, their bodily conception of life will become less and less.
然后因为这样的话呢，逐一渐进的就会使他们的这个躯体化的概念减少。
Just simply takes time.
但是呢，这是需要花时间的。
So you just continue to do this chanting, and continue with your devotional service.
所以说要做的事情呢，就是继续的念诵，继续的去从事奉爱服务。
And certainly, gradually, that conception of the material body will be diminished. It must happen.
而且呢，慢慢的、慢慢的，就是关于这个躯体化概念的这个认同就会烟消云散。这件事情是一定会发生的。
And Krishna will make arrangements for you to gradually become purified.
而且呢 ，Krishna 是会为这样的奉献者做出安排，让这样的奉献者慢慢的就会变得净化了。
Prabhupada explains in the Bhagavad Gita.Chapter 10, text number 11.
Srila Prabhupada 在博迦梵歌的第十章的第十一世界里面解释。
In the purport, Prabhupada explains that one may be the member of a spiritual institution, but he may not have the full intelligence to understand how to become purified.
在要旨里面，释迦牟尼佛就说这个奉献者他也许是一个灵性团体里面的成员，但是呢，他也许可能没有足够的智慧去知道如何能够达到完全的净化。
So Krishna makes arrangements for his, from the heart, Krishna makes arrangements to arrange for that person to become more enlightened so that they can achieve perfection.
但是呢 ，Krishna 会在这个人的内心中去做出一些安排。让这个人得到启迪，得到启明启化，然后呢，使得这个人慢慢的能够变得更加的清朗。
Sometimes we cannot understand how we're progressing in devotional service.
那有的时候呢，我们是没有办法理解我们是怎么在奉爱服务中前行的。
And we think I'm just the same. I haven't changed. I've still got this bodily conception of life.
那我们就会觉得我一直都没有任何的变化，那我一直呢还是抓着这个躯体的概念不放。
But I think anybody who's chanting every day and who's listening to the lectures every day, then I don't think they can be in the bodily conception of life.
但是呢，我觉得如果要是一个人他每天都能念诵，每天都能够聆听这些这个课程的话，他就不可能还。处在他的这个躯体化的概念的生活中。
You may be thinking you're in the bodily conception of life. That's just your humility.
也许可能您觉得您是处在这个躯体化的概念里面，但是呢，这也只能解释为是因为您的谦卑而导致的。
So you just continue to do this chanting.But Prabhupada gives the example. He said, just like you go in an airplane.So one minute the airplane is on the ground, and the next minute it's up in the sky over the city. You're 1,000 feet up in the air. You didn't notice any change, but you're up in the air.
所以说呢，就我们要做的事情呢，就是不断的再去念诵就好了。就像释迦牟尼佛给我们举了一个例子，他说我们就好像是坐在这个飞机里面，在这一分钟这飞机还在地上，但在下一分钟呢，这个飞机它已经是这个腾空而起了。虽然说我们可能没有觉得自己发生了任何变化，但此时我们已经在了空中。
So we don't notice how we're progressing in our devotional service, but if every day you're chanting and hearing, you must be progressing.
那所以说呢，我们并不知道我们在奉爱服务的这个路途中是怎么前行的。但是如果要是我们每天都在念诵，每天都在聆听的话，我们是一定会前进的。
Okay.Yeah.
Yes, Marge. Thank you. 然后呢，是苏比特桑卡玛吉的进一步问题。然后他说，什么样的人算是真正的奉献者？ 有的所谓的贡献者对其他的贡献者的一些优点会产生嫉妒，而且做得非常的明显，这样做是冒犯吗？对他自己会有恶报反应吗？ And the next part of the question from Sugita Sangamaji, she is asking that what kind of person can be considered as a real devotee? And for some so-called devotees, they are they're actually very jealous to the other devotees who are doing better than them. And this jealousy showed them very obvious. So if this is a kind of offense, and this type of offense will bring her some bad karma, bad reactions.
Yes, well, we have to be very careful in dealing with devotees. We should think everyone's a real devotee. Anyone who's chanting the holy name, they're a real devotee.
就是当我们在和奉献者一起交往的时候呢，我们要非常的小心。那么我们应该认为任何一个在念诵圣名的奉献者都是真正的奉献者。
We heard yesterday, Lord Chaitanya was describing, anyone who chants the holy name one time, he should be considered a devotee.
那就像在昨天的课程中我们就听到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，任何一位哪怕是念诵圣名一遍的人，我们都应该认为他是一位奉献者。
Anyone who accepts the prasadam of Lord Krishna is a devotee.
那么任何一位接受了主菩萨的 prasadam 的人，他都是真正的奉献者。
So we should think everyone's a devotee. Only me, I'm not a devotee.
所以呢，我们应该认为其他的人都是奉献者，除了我自己之外，我自己不是，还不是奉献者。
So we want to get the blessings of all the other devotees. Please bless me that I can also become a devotee.
所以我们希望呢，是从其他的奉献者那儿得到祝福，请祝福我也能够成为一名奉献者。
And so somebody, sometimes in dealings with each other, sometimes there may be some nasty, some bitterness or some bad feelings towards each other, not very proper, not very gentle or sweet.
那么但是在和其他的奉献者在交流的过程中呢，有的时候可能是会有一些苦涩，然后呢可能是会有一些打压，然后呢有一些这个彼此之间不是非常的甜美的相互的交流。
So, just like one time Srila Prabhupada was giving a lecture and some man was sitting listening to the lecture, but then suddenly in the middle of the lecture, the man stood up and began to shout at Prabhupada and shout nasty things, and then he just walked out.
那么就好像有一次Srila Prabhupada在讲课的时候呢，底下坐着一个人，那么就当这个课讲到一半的时候呢，这人突然站起来，然后呢就开始大声的向Srila Prabhupada吼，并且呢向他这个说了很多的脏话，然后呢这个人就走了，就离开了。
So Prabhupada said to the devotees, he said, I must have offended him in my previous life.
然后呢Srila Prabhupada就对奉献者们说，我肯定是在前世的时候冒犯过他。
So if somebody is not dealing very nice with us, very harsh, and maybe we think they're envious or something, so we should think maybe I did something wrong to them in the past.
那所以说，如果要是有人对我们不好，对我们非常刻薄，或者是展现出对我们的嫉妒的话，我们就应该在想，肯定是我在前世或者在我之前的时候做了一些对不起他的事儿。
So the idea is we have to be tolerant in our dealings with devotees.
所以呢，在这里面的要点就是，当我们在和奉献者之间在相互呼应的时候呢，我们应该容忍。
People are coming into Krishna consciousness. We're coming out of the material world, so the material world is very hard place, and there's so much suffering and nasty dealings in the material world.
那么人们呢离开了物质世界，来到了不是那知觉之中，但是呢他们在物质世界里面呢是非常的痛苦的，因为在物质世界里面有很多的艰难，有很多的这个不如意的地方。
But now they've somehow by some good fortune they've come to Krishna consciousness. They're trying to be a devotee.
但是呢就 ，sorry，
they're trying to be devotees.
但是呢，就是由于某种考虑，使得他们来到了 Krishna 知觉里面，并且呢，他们在努力着想让自己成为奉献者。
So we have to be tolerant and we have to try to help them, and sometimes we have to put up with their bad behavior and their bad dealings.
那所以说呢，我们就必须要容忍，我们就必须呢要和他们交好，然后有的时候呢我们也必须要去忍受他们的不当的行为。
In Christianity, they would talk about something about being tolerant. They would say if somebody hits you on one side of the face, you should turn your face to the other side so that they can hit the other side.
那就比如说在这个基督教里面，对于容忍是有这样一个说法，就是某人打了你的一边脸，你要把你的另外一边脸撑过去让他打。
But if somebody is doing something bad to us, we definitely don't want to think about trying to get revenge on them.
但是呢，如果要是有人对我们不好的话呢，我们肯定不能够想要报复这个人。
Sometimes we say an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth.
有的时候我们会说以牙还牙，以眼还眼。
So if we follow that, that will not be good, because then none of us will have any eyes and we won't have any teeth.
那就如果我们不能够遵循这个以牙还牙，以眼还眼的这个原则，因为如果这样的话呢，我们所有的人都没有眼睛跟牙了，都被打掉了。
So we have to learn to just tolerate and just say thank you, Krishna. Thank you, Krishna.
那所以说呢，我们就要学着去容忍，然后呢和 Krishna 说谢谢 Krishna, 谢谢 Krishna.
Krishna, and that I meant to suffer more, but Krishna's reduced my suffering.
Krishna, 本来我应该受更多苦的，但是呢你减少了我的痛苦，减少了我要受的苦。
So it's difficult, of course, it's a test, but we should see all of these situations as a test from Krishna.
虽然说其实经历这些呢并不容易，这些都是对我们的试炼，但是我们要看到所有的这些都是 Sri Krishna 给我们的考题，在考验我们。
It is said if somebody praises you,then they're your enemy, because we like praise. We think, yeah, I'm a great devotee, I'm really good.
那有这样一个说法，就是如果是有人在表扬你的话，其实表扬你的这个人才是你的敌人，因为我们大家都喜欢听表扬的话，你们一听说就会说，哎呀，你就会他表扬以后就让我们觉得，哎呀，你说我做的真的特别好，我真的是一位特别大的奉献者。
And if somebody criticizes us, they're really our friend, because they're helping us to see our own faults.
而批评我们的人呢，其实才是我们真正的朋友，因为他们的批评使我们能够看到我们的缺点，看到我们的错误。
It's hard for us, it's painful, but we have to tolerate these things. It's purifying.
那么这个对我们来说其实是挺难的，而且呢也是挺痛苦的，但是呢我们就必须要容忍，因为这个对我们来说是进化。
So this is my advice to you in this situation.
所以说呢，这是我对于您处在这样的情形下的一些建议。
Just try to tolerate andIn course of time, it will pass. Just encourage that devotee in their devotional service. Encourage everyone in their devotional service.
那所以呢，假以时日，一切都会过去的，是容忍就好了。而且呢，我们要鼓励所有的奉献者能够，或者鼓励这位奉献者，然后努力的去做奉爱服务。
But this is how you advance. The more you tolerate these situations.
但是呢，这个就是我们这个进步的方式。我们越容忍这样的情形，我们就越能够进步。
Okay.
Yes, Maharaj. All of the.And questions, yes, and Yuna, Mataji, Panchatattva Prabhu, and Suvita Sangha Mataji show their great attitude to you for your wonderful answer. Thank you very much.
Okay, so we'll stop here today, this morning?
Yes. 那我们今天早晨就这课就先停在这儿。Thank you so much, Mara.
So are you coming in the afternoon or is it Sugita, Gita, Guru Mani?
Guru Mani Maji will translate, but I will attend the class, I will listen.
Okay. So thank you very much again for your translation. And thank all the devotees for listening.
感恩所有的奉献者的聆听。
I'm very happy to hear from all of you.
马尔真的非常非常的开心，能够听到大家来参加这个课，而且呢，能够听到大家的提问。
So please stay happy and healthy and stay in Krishna consciousness and hope to see you in the future sometime.
No, Marj, this afternoon.
Oh, this afternoon, yeah.
One second.
See
you
in the afternoon, yeah. Okay.
Yeah. 所以呢，我们今天下午的时候呢，还有最后一次，在这个就是在这次的这个十一的期间，能够听到你像Marj的甘露的一个机会，所以我们今天下午的时候四点半的时候再见。我们非常非常的感恩马哈吉为我们的精彩讲述以及对所有的问题的耐心解答。谢谢 Subhadi Raya Prabhu 为我们的主持，感恩所有的奉献者的聆听以及提出的好问题。我们下午再见，祝大家。